Let's create these two grid assets that we have in our Revit project that we can model them in Revit. You can see the detail and the high quality of this asset that before this feature in Enscape we couldn't use them, or if we could, they would be very heavy for Revit and our performance would get slower and slower after using them. But Enscape has some proxy politic here, but when you render them you will see the high detail asset, but when you are in the viewport you can see there are some proxies, for example boxes, rectangles and something like that. Okay, before anything I should tell you to tips about this custom asset. The first one is that when you are creating these assets or you are downloading these assets, it is recommended by Enscape to have a triangular polygons modeling method, and also that should be under 20,000 polygons. Enscape can import assets with more than of that, but it can reduce your performance. And the second tip is here is to do the texturing process in your native software. For example, if you're doing assets or unwrapping, you should do that on your native software, for example 3ds studio max and Blender or other kind of softwares, for example, other kind of 3D softwares that allow you to model these great assets. And the formats that Enscape support, at the time that we are recording this video, which is Enscape 3, it will support GLTF, OBJ, and FBX. Okay, let us start to create your asset. You need to go to the Enscape tab and after that click on Asset Library. And you have to wait, and when your asset library has pop up, you go to the custom asset part, and from here you can click on your create new asset in custom asset editor. But if you have created some assets and custom assets and you want to share them with your friends or with your clients, you just need to send them the library and after that they can browse them from here. Okay, let's click on the plus sign and after that we can create a asset. You will see a new window that will come up that is called Enscape Custom Asset Editor, that you can import the geometry, scale it, and create thumbnail, and also give it title, and also assign in the textures. For example, I'll click on here, import geometry, and from the where you have downloaded your files, you can import them. For example, I have this wood table that I have five different LOD of this asset we are seeing here, this table. I'm going to use the LOD level 4 because it wouldn't reduce my performance on my software. So click it and click on open and it will import your asset here. Okay, this is not the nice thing here. The first of all, you need to reduce the scale. It is not 1700 meters. For example, this scale here is near to the real life. You just need to change the scale in one direction, and the other direction will change appropriately, and it will keep the ratio. For example, let me put it at 1 meter. It will reduce the size of it. To move in this viewport, you should do the exact configuration with your Enscape. For example, you can work with WDSA, and also you can look around with your left click, and also you can move faster with shift and control. So for example, I'm going to get nearer to this. Okay, this is for our scales and our importing geometry. You can title it to find it easier after it. For example, I'm going to call it table custom, and you can also add some descriptions here. And after that, from here you have different types. For example, if you change them, it will change the parameters in the map style. For example, if I would change them on grass, the model isn't going to respond because it's a default object. If it's going to be full age or other kind of things, you need to put them, you need to specify them first from here. Let me put it on default, and from here, let me first assign the albedo map or diffuse map from here. And then you can see our model is going to get some life. And after that, let's go to the, we don't have any self illumination or transparency. We have a height map. In this part, we can use all of the maps that we have. For example, we have displacement map, height map, and normal map. But here, Enscape just allows to use one of them. For example, for this asset, the normal map would work better than other one. So click on the sign here. I'm going to choose the normal map. And also you should assign it as a normal map from here. You can adjust it and tell the Enscape which map it is. It is a normal map, and also you can change the intensity here. For example, if I would change it to a lower number, it will be better, or you can change it to higher numbers. Okay, it is okay for now. Also in reflection, I have a roughness map too. I'm going to assign it from here, and it is okay. And I don't have any metallicness in this asset, so I'm going to bring it down. It is a wood, not a metal. Also, I'm going to change the specular too. Okay, it is the end, and the last step is to create a thumbnail for it to search it and see the thumbnail with the view you want. Just click on here and create a thumbnail for it. Now the thumbnail has saved, and the next step is to save this project somewhere. One tip here: if you want to edit this, edit the scale or edit the maps later, you need to keep the save project. The asset and this project of editor is the separate file, so keep it in your mind and save them in two places, not in one place. First, save the project from here. Because I have created this project, I'm going to create and generate asset, and it will tell you that you should save your project. Click on the save project. I'm going to save it on my desktop in here, and then you can create and generate asset, and it will tell you the message that generate as asset have been generated. Click on close, and from here also click on close. You should wait a little bit here to Enscape to switch the window to Enscape asset library, and then you can use it very easy. Search the name of the asset here, for example, table underline custom. Now you can see our asset here. Now, so we have the edit asset option too, and you just need to click on here and place it everywhere in the project you want. For example, I can place it here or here. Because I have placed them before, you can see here the placement. Let me put it on none mode to see the textures and the details. Now you can see the detail. I have done the same with the statue too, with the sculpture too. You can do it for your exercise too. I'm not going to do that again because the video length is going to be high.